The Bottle Works Ethnic Art Center in the Cambria City section of Johnstown isn't just home to works of art. In many ways, it is one itself. Thousands of tiny tiles adorn the outside of the building, making it one of the biggest artistic pieces in the city.
It's a landmark, and I think it really is a showpiece. One of the reasons that people are drawn into the Bottle Works more is because they have become involved in the public art project. People came to work on the mosaic who had never been here. And of course, then they had to come and find out where the mosaic was going to be. So we have all of those volunteers who come and take pictures and stand in front of them.
Beth Elston, who is now the activity director for the center, worked on the mosaic with her husband and children.
It was a really fun way to spend a few hours on a Saturday. It was very relaxing to just sit and clip tile, glue tile, talk to some people, meet some new folks, to see something come to, you know, to finish and to finally see it on the outside of the building. It was just a huge project. You couldn't imagine it while you were working on it, but when it was all finished, it was really pretty stunning.
The Bottle Works first opened nearly two decades ago after a realization that the people in the region had a desire to reconnect with their heritage.
The inspiration came from, it was more of a mandate, came from the response to the centennial celebration of 1989, which was the anniversary of the Great Flood. And it actually celebrated the spirit of the people of Johnstown and the resilience and so forth. Following that centennial celebration, there was 3 years of National Folk Festival, during which time everyone became very proud to be Irish or Italian or German or Slovak or whatever they were, and they wore t-shirts and so forth. And so this happened for 3 years in a row over Labor Day, and some folks got together and said, wouldn't it be great to have a celebration of ethnicity all year round, every day of the year? And so we decided to form this organization known as the Bottle Works Ethnic Arts Center. We are an educational organization, and we find it's our obligation to try to help people learn more about themselves and learn more about others. And actually, by doing that, then we become more connected, because sometimes the more we find out about our differences, the more we find our similarities. So it's a world peace kind of symbol.
Both the name and the iconic tulips that symbolize the Bottle Works are linked to the past the center is working to preserve with its mission. The building was the former home of the Tulip Bottling Company, which was founded by Jacob and Renee Goldhaber and named after the national flower of Hungary.
Esther is the was a member of the Goldhaber family, and she has been very, very supportive of this organization. So this gallery space, we put exhibits here. This is part of our Black History exhibit this month. And inside in the theater, we use that for exhibit also. But it also serves as a terrific performing space. It's a very live room.
This is the Catter Theater. It's a black box theater. We use this for a lot of our programming, such as classes for dance, for yoga. We use it for concerts, lectures. We use it for rentals. People will use it for baby showers or birthday parties or things like that. And we also use the wall space for exhibits. And the current exhibit in here right now is by Gregory Thompson of Johnstown, a self-taught artist. And he's had a great response.
Space may be limited on the inside, but the center is planning an outdoor expansion.
We will be digging all of this up for a garden, and our hope is that we will be able to find the support necessary to make this 30-foot bottle, which actually accommodates four benches and, you know, X number of people. But we just think it would just be extremely inviting to anyone who comes down to this neighborhood.
Pulaski said the biggest asset that the Bottle Works has is the people of Johnstown.
Our resources are the people within the community. They're the ones that go up to their attics or pull things out of their chests and so forth, and find someone to tell the story. It's just been very rewarding. We have met so many neat people. The nice thing about celebrating different heritages is that every audience that we have is different. So you rarely see the, you always find the same people who are interested in everything, but you will find different audiences for each of the shows, and we like that.